morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning, teacher.
That's for you've heard that before, haven't you?
You get apples, why?
They still get apples, no?
Oh, shoot. That used to be fun. Give the teacher the things that you didn't want to eat, didn't you? They were great. We're going to talk about praising the Lord today, and I hope that you're up for that, because our readings, our songs, all the things that we're talking about are based upon Psalm 113, which starts out, "Praise the Lord, praise, O servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord." And we're going to talk about that in our message for today, and in our children's talk, and in our prayers, and you name it, we're going to do it. It is good to have you here. If there's anybody who's a visitor here, we're glad to have you. The Lord's richest blessings on your worship. If you do see somebody you don't know, make sure that you introduce yourself and welcome them back. And you can always tell them, "Am I new here or are you?" I can't always do that for you because I don't know which ones are just coming back for a visit and are already members here, and those who are just here as visitors. So make sure that you greet them with a smile, a handshake, and spread the love around, as it were. We're going to be starting with a special song that these young ladies have put together for us. And the opening song is, "You Are Worthy of My Praise." And you have the words in your worship folder for today, or they'll be up on the screen. Anyway, the Lord bless your worship.
All of my days,
I will follow
all of your ways,
all of your ways.
I will give you
all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my
praise.
I will bow down
and hail you as King.
I will serve you.
Give you everything.
I will lift up.
My eyes to your throne. I will trust you.
I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise.
You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy.
Shall we rise as we join in our worship for today? And this order of worship is up on our screen or in our worship folder as we make our beginnings in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Join together with these opening sentences with me. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Let not steadfast love and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding.
In all your ways acknowledge Him,
and He will make straight your path. Let us humble ourselves before God, confess our sins to Him, and ask His gracious forgiveness for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. We confess to You, Lord God Almighty, before the whole company of heaven and before one another, that we are sinful human beings by nature and by deed. We have not always put You first. We have Your name in the ways that do not honor You. We have not always been devoted to You, our Lord, and have not fully praised Your holy name. We have failed in ways of keeping Your thoughts, words, and deeds pure and honorable. We pray You to have mercy on us, to give us our sins, and to bring us to everlasting life. Amen. The Almighty and merciful God grants us pardon, forgiveness, and remission of all of our sins. As a called and ordained servant of the Word, it is my privilege to be able to say that our sins are forgiven us in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today we look at Psalm 113. Let us recite these words together as a congregation. Praise the Lord. Praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from this time forth and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to its setting, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, and His glory above the heathen. Who is like the Lord our God, who is seated on high, who looks far down on the heavens and the earth? He raises the poor from the dust, and lifts the needy from the ash heap, to make them sit with the princes of His people. He gives the barren woman a home, making her the joyous mother of children. Praise the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, You call us to be faithful in very little in order to be trusted with much. Preserve us by Your perpetual mercy, and because without You we cannot but fall. Keep us from all things hurtful and lead us to all things profitable to our salvation. For You live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The Old Testament reading is from the book of Amos, the 8th chapter. Hear this, you who trample on the needy and bring the poor of the land to an end, saying, when will the new moon be over, that we may sell grain, and the Sabbath, that we may offer wheat for sale, that we may make the epeth small and the shekel great, and deal deceitfully with false balances, that we may buy the poor for silver and the needy for a pair of sandals and sell the chaff of the wheat. The Lord has sworn by the pride of Jacob, surely I will never forget any of their deeds. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle lesson is from the book of 1 Timothy, the second chapter. First of all, then, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for all people, for kings and all who are in high positions, that we may lead a peaceful and quiet life, godly and dignified in every way. This is good and it is pleasing in the sight of God our Savior, who desires all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, and there is one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all, which is the testimony given at the proper time. For this I was appointed a preacher and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying. A teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. I desire then that in every place the men should pray, lifting holy hands without anger or quarreling. Likewise also, that women should adorn themselves in respectable apparel with modesty and self-control, not with braided hair and gold or silver or pearls or costly attire, but with what is proper for women who profess godliness with good works. Let a woman learn quietly with all submissiveness. Do not permit a woman to teach or to exercise her authority over a man, rather she is to remain quiet. For Adam was formed first, then Eve, and Adam was not deceived, but the woman was deceived and became a transgressor. Yet she will be saved through childbearing if they continue in faith and love and holiness with self-control. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'm glad you read that epistle, Steve. Yeah, Ellie reading it earlier, and that submissiveness just wouldn't come out. I mean, she stumbled over that word. She just says, that's just not my word for that. That's kind of cute. Sometimes the Lord's words are hard, I'll tell you. We're going to be singing a song called To God Be the Glory. Fanny Crosby wrote the lyrics to this and the music by Howard Doane. This was back in 1875. I'm going to sing the chorus for you first so you get the hang of it, okay? Many of you know it, but maybe not. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus, his Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. To God be the glory, great things he has done. So loved he the world that he gave us his Son, who yielded his life and atonement for sin, and open the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. Oh, redemption, the purchase of blood, to every believer the promise of God. The mildest offender who truly believes, that moment from Jesus a pardon receive. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Come to the Father through Jesus his Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. Great things he has taught us, great things he has done. Great our rejoicing through Jesus the Son, but purer and higher and greater will be our wonder, our transport when Jesus we see. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice.
come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus his Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done.
Shall we rise out of respect for the Holy Gospel that Jeff is going to be sharing with us in a moment?
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 16th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus also said to the disciples, "There was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that this man was wasting his possessions. And he called him and said to him, 'What is this that I hear about you? Turn in the account of your management, for you can no longer be a manager.' And the manager said to himself, 'What shall I do, since my master is taking the management away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do, so that when I am removed from management, people may receive me into their homes.' So, summoning his master's debtors one by one, he said to the first, 'How much do you owe my master?' He said, 100 measures of oil. He said to him, 'Take your bill and sit down quickly and write 50. Then he said to another, "And how much do you owe?" He said, 100 measures of wheat. He said to him, "Take your bill and write 80. The master commended the dishonest manager for his shrewdness. For the sons of this world are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than with the sons of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of unrighteous wealth, so that when it falls, they may receive you into the eternal dwellings. One who is faithful in a very little is also faithful in much. And one who is dishonest in a very little is also dishonest in much. If then you have not been faithful in the unrighteous wealth, who will entrust you with the true riches? And if you have not been faithful in that which is another, who will give you that which is your own? No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money." The Pharisees, who were lovers of money, heard all these things, and they ridiculed him. And he said to them, "You are those who justify yourselves before men, but God knows your heart. For what is exalted among men is an abomination in the sight of God." This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Thank you. You may be seated. I'd like to have the kids come forward, if we could. How about if you are a child, come on down, and as they're coming, we'll sing a little bit. Jesus loves me, this I know. Let's sit over here. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Let's see who we waving at. Okay. It is good to see all of you kids. Hey, you know what we're talking about? We're talking today about praising the Lord. And you know, sometimes you just wake up and you feel good, don't you? I feel good. Da 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 da. I know that I would now. Sometimes you just wake up and you have a smile on your face. Sometimes things just seem to be going your way. You get your outfit on, you're ready for school, and you're looking good. And you're just walking along and you're bouncing. And it's easy when you feel like that, when everything is right in the world, when God is in the heaven, the sky is blue, the grass is green, and everything seems okay, to go, praise the Lord. Let's try that. 1, 3, ready? 1, 2, 3. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm going to teach you the sign that goes with praise the Lord, okay? Usually, you go out, praise is like you're going to say praise. So you go, praise the Lord. Remember that from VBS? It's like that. So we go, praise. So it's like we're saying praise the Lord. Okay, try it with me. Go, praise the Lord. The Lord is, okay? Now, there's a second half that it's going to be going along, but we'll wait for just a second. You know, it's easy to praise the Lord when we're happy and we're feeling good, but what about when we're not feeling happy? And we get up and we're going, oh, the sun. Yes, ma'am. Well, I will. I'll try to give everybody a happy message. Thank you for that. I've been set straight. But what if you're feeling really low and you get up in the morning and you're going, I got to go to school and I don't want to wear this outfit and oh man, I don't want this cereal and I don't want to go to class and I don't like the person that's sitting next to me and I don't want to go out to recess and go, woo, and run around like I'm crazy. I don't want to. You like that? You think that's funny, but it's not. That's for the adults too. Okay, but is it possible that when we're really dragging along and we're feeling down, that we should go, praise the Lord? You think so? Yeah, it makes you feel better, don't it? It don't feel good when you walk around going, I don't like it, you don't feel it, welcome, my parents. No, try instead going, you know, I don't feel that well today, but praise the Lord. Remember what I said it is? Praise the Lord. Okay? And there's another section to this little song we're going to sing. It's called Praise the Lord Together, Singing Hallelujah. Hallelujah means praise the Lord too. Praise the Yahweh. And what we do is praise the Lord. We know that part, right? Now, hallelujah is like this. You got to go like your fingers, like you guys are going to help. So like this, like you got two little hooks, right? Sometimes people like to go, whoop, and then they go praise, like you're holding banners. Remember this? We had some of this in VBS. Praise the Lord, okay? An hallelujah. That's another way of saying it. So you go, whoop, hallelujah. Okay? So you put it all together. Let's put it together. Praise the Lord. And the other one is hallelujah. All right. Now the song is like this. It goes, praise the Lord together, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, sing it with me first, then we'll put the signs together. It's simple, right? Praise the Lord together, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's try putting the signs with it, okay? Praise the Lord together, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Now, try that. Try the next time that you're happy, great. You can go, woo-hoo, praise the Lord, right? You get down there and do those splits like, James Brown used to do and all of that. And you can walk along happy and you're singing. But try when you're feeling really down sometimes just to go, well, praise the Lord anyway. Okay? So, glad to have you come on up. Why don't you go on back to your seat because I'm going to make them sing. Yeah. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Now it's your turn. You heard that song? Sing it with me. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. You can make the signs. Alleluia. Alleluia. Okay, this is what I want you to do. Mr. Smith, he's the one who's a mathematician. Okay, here we go. I want you to sing that through five times and ignore what I'm going to do. All right, can you do that? Let's practice it one more time. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Okay, sing it through five times. Ready? Y'all ready? Crack your neck, take a breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. All right, everybody ready? Here we go. Praise the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Again. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. 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 Right? Oh, you're getting up. Wait. Ignore what I'm doing. Okay. Ignore what I'm singing. We're going to start over. Don't worry about the signs right now, okay? Let's do it again. We'll start it five times in a row, okay? I'm going to be singing just a little behind you, okay? Here we go. Ready? We'll start again. Praise the Lord together. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. 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 Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. 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 Got it. Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. 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 Praise the Lord together, singing alleluia. 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 See, you got it. It was just the signs that were messing us up. Good job, folks. Good job. Let's see. Next, we are going to do our sermon song.
And that is Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Let me get it rolling here.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee, praising thee, the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the gloom of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. All thy works rejoice around thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays, stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, all of to rejoice in thee. Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed. Wellspring of the joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Thou our Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love are thine. Teach us how to love each other, lift us to thy joy divine.
My words are a little bit different. Imagine that. That's what I get for not singing straight out of the hymn book.
That's all right. The Lord expects perfection out of us. When we can't do it, he'll accept the big TR line. Ode to Joy. You know, it is wonderful to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We read that in Psalm 113 just a little bit ago. Praise the Lord, praise, O servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. You know, it's easy to praise the Lord when you're glad. Like we said with the kids, when you get up and all seems well with the world, and it's easy to go outside and smell the fresh air, and look at the beautiful sky. Know that you're alive. You feel like beating your chest, go, ah! That's Jane. And you feel like going, praise the Lord. And then we talked about the sad times. There are times that we are very much sad because the world doesn't seem to want to revolve around us and things don't seem to go the way that we want to go. And it's sad. Sometimes we just wake up with this, what they call melancholy, or they used to. And then you used to have what? That we have bipolar, and they keep coming up with different names. I have a whole family. We used to actually order Prozac by the gross because it runs rampant in our family. Sometimes you feel like, yoo-hoo! Praise Jesus. And other times you're going, you made me like this. My sister told my dad that one time. She looked at him and said, it ain't my fault. You made me. And that didn't go over well. My sister was kind of a hefty gal, and I could hear, this is what it was like on a Sunday morning at my house. You could hear her going, slamming the door in her bedroom, and you hear, open this door, open this door. That's how we would start a Sunday morning. But you know, it's hard to praise the Lord when we are sad. And there are a lot of sad things about this world. We look at the world situation and the hurting people over in the Ukraine. Or we think about the people that we have, quote, lost, unquote. So many people that have been taken away from us for a while. You know, those people that are our parents, or we're of an age now where our friends start being taken away, and sometimes it's our spouses, sometimes it's our own kids. You talk to people like Dar Williams, 100 years, he's pretty much outlived most of his friends and his wife and his lady friend, and if he lives much longer, he'll outlive a lot of us. You know, there's a sad part to it, and it's hard just to look at the Lord in the sad times and say, praise the Lord. Remember, Jesus even wept, and that smallest little verse we have in Scripture, in the New Testament, in John chapter 11, where it says that Jesus felt the hurt of the people around him because they were weeping and moaning because Lazarus had died. And Jesus felt that hurt and he wept. So God knows our sadness. It's not just that he sets us down on this earth and he sets us on our way. Try that with your little kids. You know, you have kids and they become toddlers and you help them down the driveway and down the street. Say, come on back when you're 21. Hope you have a nice life. Go to a good college, make good grades. Come on back and visit me. but don't stay for too long when you come back. God is there along with the sadness. You know, those tears of sadness will one day be replaced by tears of joy. We're told that in Revelation 21, that every tear will be wiped away from the eye. So we have reason to praise the Lord even in the saddest of times, because the end is not the end at all, but just the beginning of life everlasting with Him. And along with those tears, our Lord comes to wipe them away. What about the good times? Let the good times roll. Psalm 27 says, I am confident that I will get the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You know, sometimes things are good. Aren't they good? I was jokingly saying, I feel good. But things are good because we have a lot to be thankful for in this world, don't we? You all are rich people. And you're going, oh yeah, you don't see my bank account. You don't see what my balance is. Yeah, but you got stuff. You got cars, sometimes more than one. I know they're not up on concrete blocks. I don't think they allow them in this neighborhood. My neighborhood, yeah, as long as it doesn't go out into the street, you can have as many tractors, cars, and other wheeled paraphernalia sitting around all you want, so you can't hardly see through the weeds and see the house. You know, but we've been blessed. We've got things. We have been blessed with so much. Our Lord has, like that cup in the 23rd Psalm, keeps pouring blessing upon blessing. He gives us everything that we need to support our body and our life until we are that cup that runs over. But what about the bad times? What about when we don't have enough to pay our bills? What about the times when we blow the brake lines on our car, when we get that telephone call late in the night that our son or our daughter has had an accident, or in my case, that they're in jail? That's an interesting one. What about those bad times when it doesn't seem like we're getting along with our kids or getting along with our husband or our wife or our parents? What about the bad times that we have when things are not going well at work? You know, we are not promised that everything is going to be a rose garden down here. I never promised you a rose garden. It's worse than that. God actually says, through many tribulations must you enter the kingdom of heaven. And that's from Acts 14, verse 22. Why should we give praise to our Lord during the bad times? Because along with those bad times, He comes along. He is there to build us up, to buoy us up, to work even the bad things in our life together for our benefit. Isn't that what it says at the end of Romans chapter 8? All things work together for good for those who love the Lord, who are called according to His purpose. So when you have bad times, praise the Lord, because He's there watching out and helping us to work through those bad times. It's easy to praise the Lord when our life is easy. Sometimes everything goes in its place. Sometimes everything seems to be coming our way. Everything's coming up roses, as the old song used to say. And we have those times as well. When you're out there working on your car and this little piece slips right in there and it's the right thing and you don't have to take it back and you got the other adapter in there and it's like, oh yeah, it's so easy. But what about when you pull that car out and all of a sudden the brake line bursts and you have transmission fluid all over because you had another car in there and you got a little thing that collects all the old transmission fluid, and on the way out the car flipped that over on your nice clean garage floor, and all the way out you're looking at this line realizing that you have just squirted out about 8 ounces of brake fluid because the line broke. What about then? Is it easy to say, well, praise Jesus? No, it's not. We go through those hard times. I'm just talking about working on the car. But there are hard times. You know, there are difficult times for a lot of us in this world. It doesn't always come out easy, and it doesn't always come out with a happy ending, it seems like. An Irish story is one that never has a happy ending. Life sucks and then you die. What about then? Is that what our future is going to be? Is that reason to praise our Lord? Well, it is in this, because Jesus said to his disciples when he sent them out at the end of Matthew, what? Lo, I will be with you always, even unto the ends of this earth. We read this in Psalm 113. He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the needy from the ash heap. He makes them sit with princes. The hard times come, but we praise our Lord because along with the hard times, our Lord comes with. He says, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. He's there to lift us up, pick us up, and if necessary, carry us along life's way. That's reason to rejoice and praise our Lord. What about those troubling times that we have? And I mean those times when you start waking up. It's always 3:13 in the morning and you wake up and you think, how in the world could I have done that? Why am I the way that I am? We start doubting ourselves. We start looking over our lives and realizing we were not the perfect children that we started out to be, or at least our parents thought. Don't you remember looking at that newborn baby and going, oh yeah, an eye on either side of the head. I don't know about that third eye, but we can take care of that later. And the ears and the toes, and then it's there, and it's so cute. Remember they used to just pull that baby out, lift it up, and go, ah! And they'd hand it to you like a chicken? No, not quite. Now they just place the baby on the mommy's tummy, and you're looking at that little baby, and it looks so beautiful. And dad is sitting there. He's still got his sore hand from where the wife is holding onto his hand and broke every knuckle in that particular hand when she was giving birth. But you know, we stray from that and we realize that our children are not perfect. We were not perfect children. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Is that reason to praise our Lord when we're troubled like that? When we start realizing that there are things that we should have done that we didn't do and accomplish? Things that we should have said and we failed to say? Oh, we're good at saying the wrong things and doing the wrong things. And our thoughts always betray us. We come together in corporate worship and we say, we have sinned against thee by thought and by word and by deed. But you know, we can praise our Lord even in those troubling times because they are paired with forgiving times. Steve just read that, those words from our epistle for today, right? The Lord would that all people come to know Jesus, to the knowledge of Christ. And that's why we have reason to rejoice, because our Lord doesn't let us just stay in our sinfulness. He just doesn't write us off, but He comes a-looking, and He finds us, and He makes sure that our pathways are smoothed out. He makes sure that He is there to show us that we are forgiven children. He is there to show us that this life is not all we have, but that we're headed for the wonderful portals of heaven above. We praise our Lord even for the end times, because all of us, it is appointed for us to live and die, and after that comes the judgment. And it's not a frightful thing for us. It's something that one day we will be there before the throne of God, joined together with all the saints and all the martyrs and all the angels of heaven, and be able to praise our Lord and see Him face to face. That's our future. This is the day that the Lord has made. You're going to be singing that, aren't you? Let us rejoice and be glad in it, from Psalm 118. Because there will come that day, as we have seen in the book of Revelation, that there will be no more hunger, no more thirst. Every tear shall be wiped from the eye, and the last enemy to be destroyed is death. You hear me talk about that a lot, because that is our future. We don't have an Irish story. We have a Christian story. Our Lord is with us from the moment that we are conceived until the moment that we draw our last breath, and we live with Him forevermore. And if that's not reason to praise the Lord, I don't know what is. There was a friend that I went to college with, John H. We called John H. and John T. There were two cousins that had the name John. But John H. had a friend that went to the school for the deaf in Fulton, Missouri. And we would pick him up once in a while and take him to the dormitory out there in the little prep school, St. Paul's College and College High, out there in the middle of the cornfield. And we'd pick his friend up, and he couldn't hear, but he could feel. So my friend had these two great big Sony speakers, and we'd pick him up, and he'd be there in the passenger seat, and he would have John turn it all the way up so he could feel the boom, 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 boom. And the people passing on the highway are looking like, I told you, Ethel, that's why everybody's going deaf nowadays in this world. But what was really cute about this young man, I can't even remember his name, but he said that they, at the beginning of a meal, they would say their prayer like this. They would blow God a kiss and give him a big round of applause. Let's do that to finish our message. Blow God a kiss. Give him a big round of applause. In Jesus' name. And leave this big speakers go. That's not good for the rest of us. Amen and amen. Instead of speaking our creed for today, we're going to sing it. This is based on immortal, invisible, God only wise. And since we're going to be using this as our creed, why don't we rise for it? Let me turn this off. We get an odd echo on the recording when I leave this on. Start something
like this, like this. Like I'm in the tub. Let me give you the, let me just start it and we'll start over again. Let me sing it, the first verse for you, okay?
Immortal, invisible, God only wise, in light inaccessible, hid from our eyes. Most blessed, most glorious, the Ancient of Days, Almighty, victorious, thy great name we praise.
Let's start again.
Immortal, invisible, God only wise, in light accessible, hid from our eyes. Most blessed, most glorious, the Ancient of Days, Almighty, victorious, thy great name we praise. Unresting, unhasting, I'd silent as light, nor wanting, nor wasting, thou rulest in might. Thy justice like mountains high soaring above, by clouds which are fountains of goodness and love. To all life thou givest, to both great and small, in all life thou livest the true life of all. We blossom and flourish as leaves on a tree, and wither and perish, but not changes thee. Great Father of glory, pure Father of light, thine angels adore thee, all they leave their sight. All Lord we would render, oh help us to see, 'tis only the splendor of light that helps me. Immortal, invisible,
just to help keep this building in order, but this building is only housing the true church, which is you. And we can use these funds to be able to get the word out so that others might be able to praise their Lord in the good times and the bad times. Good times, bad times. You know, I've had my share. But we can praise the Lord nonetheless. We do, Heavenly Father, thank you that you have provided so well for us here in this place. Utilize these monies, Lord God, so the word might get out that we have reason to rejoice and praising your holy name, for you love us with an everlasting love. Help us, Lord God, to go forward in your name and praising your name by our life that we live and the words that we say. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, we do pray for all of those who are having difficulties or going through procedures, Lord God. They're facing surgeries. There's a lot of folks here, Lord God. They're on a regimen of treatment. They need your help, Lord God. Remind them always that you will give them a good measure of your healing touch according to your divine will. But most importantly, Lord God, remind them that they can praise your holy name because you're always there to say a resounding yes when they ask for your spiritual healing, when they ask for your strength and an indwelling of your spirit. You always shout yes, Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we do pray for all of those who are serving us in the 13,000 jurisdictions across this country, our police officers, our servicemen and women. We pray for the linemen, we pray for the street crews, we pray for the emergency workers, the firemen, the health workers, all of them, Lord God, are out there on the front line. Help them as they help us. Send your angels down to watch over them as they are watching over us. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, you have reminded us again in our psalm for today that you bring all nations before you, that they will all bow down before you. We would ask, Lord God, as you have said, you are high above the nation and his glory above the heavens. Who is like you, Lord our God? Utilize all of our world leaders and leaders in our country and our local leaders who are elected and appointed as tools in your mighty hands so that thy will be done on this earth. We make a claim again, Lord God, that you bring out of the chaos over in the Ukraine some kind of order and some kind of peace. But help the people who are there, Lord God. Give them the strength in knowing that you are there for them and have not given up on them. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we finally pray for our church as we are working through the processes that are necessary in order to get back to the call. Help us, Lord God, to know your will and know your way. Give us the wisdom that comes down from above for our transition team, for the Board of Elders, for our council, all of the folks, Lord, who are diligently working to make this a place, Lord God, where we can have an under-shepherd sent. You know who that man will be, Lord God, under the great shepherd and the good shepherd, your son. But show us who that might be and let us make preparations with your wisdom and with your guidance to get to that point. Lord, in your mercy. Finally, we raise up to you as we name in our hearts people that we are concerned about as we take this moment of silence. These are your children. Utilize us, Lord God, to reach out helping hands, to speak encouraging words. Remind us always, Lord God, to be your ambassadors wherever we might go, that we might share the joy of our salvation, that we might show that we can praise the Lord in the good times and the bad, in the glad times and the sad. Help us, Lord God, to let that light that shines through us in our praise so light upon other people that they might see the true light of the world, your Son, the Christ. Lord, in your mercy. And finally, Lord, we rise and join in the words which your Son has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made. Let's sing these words that come directly from Psalm 118. The day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. We'll give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercies endureth forever. Amen. And be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. I got a river of life flowing out of me, makes the lame to walk and the blind to see, opens prison doors and sets the captives free. I got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, O well, within my soul. Spring up, O well, and make me whole. Spring up, O well, and give to me that joy abundantly. I'll quit there. Remind you that we have council meeting on Tuesday evening. Go in peace, serve the Lord with gladness. Lift Jesus higher, lift Jesus higher. Lift him up for the world to see. He said, if I, blessings, be lifted up.